Week one of games training has begun. So, being, I'd say, an entrepreneur, I definitely try to prioritize business first, especially in the past 2 years or so. I've really tried to, you know, not let training take up the majority of my time. But since it is game season, I need to definitely make that a little bit more of a priority. So I am adding in an extra session where I would normally cram everything up into one big session. What's gonna end up happening is I'm gonna need to start taking my work home with me a little bit, which isn't, you know, the most, you know, it's not the most ideal situation, but it's gonna have to make do for now. You know, it's only 6 weeks, so you can do anything for 6 weeks. You just put your head down and get to work. We are back. Normal training after Granite Games. Today I have some sats press, some snatch pulls, and then a couple of conditioning pieces. Got to work out with legless rope climbs and cleans. Then some shoulder work, shoulder intensive work. We're going to be doing strict handstand push-ups, shoulder to overhead, weighted dubs, and a Metcon, so definitely gonna burn the shoulders out. And then we have a little burpee cash out, 50 burpees over box for time. So, if this was like a competition, I would potentially think about just breaking up those strict handstand push-ups from the start, just to kind of like, you know, plan that breakout, not go to red line. But since this is training, I'm gonna kind of go for it and see what happens. I'm gonna try to do everything unbroken. I think the jump rope is gonna get pretty spicy after a while. So we'll see what happens, but we're gonna go for it. I said I was gonna go for it round one. Clearly that was not the right plan, but it was good to do something like that so you could see where the fatigue factors are in a workout like this. So yeah, it was definitely a punch in the mouth for sure.
Starting today, I've changed my RP numbers and schedule within the app. Typically, I would start my day with a fast up until about 11 or 12 o'clock, and then fit in the rest of my meals between like 12 to 8 p.m. But now training twice a day and breaking up the sessions, I'm gonna have a meal after that first a.m. session, which takes place at 7 a.m. So I'll be eating right before I coach the 9 a.m. So just trying to get a little bit more nutrients packed in there before that second session to, one, recover from the morning session, but also have enough to get me through that second session. A lot of times when I was doing that longer session, sometimes I would just feel pretty dead by the end of it. And I wouldn't end up giving my, you know, my full effort by the end of that session, so.
Come on, Faye. Come on.
Come on.
pretty tough. Pretty happy with how the cleans went. Probably haven't cleaned this heavy since the open because of my hip. And those three reps at 305, didn't feel any pain in my hip, which is great. So that's definitely a victory for me for today, for sure.
I'm gonna be swimming twice a week. I'm gonna be doing that on Mondays and Thursdays. So getting in the pool, just accumulating a lot of meters, and then kind of like using those as like a recovery day. So try to sauna on those days and, you know, make sure I get some extra stretching in and prehab type work, just to kind of keep the body healthy with all the volume that's gonna be accumulating over the next few weeks. Training with team is gonna be Saturday and Sunday. We're gonna be doing, you know, probably 3 workouts per day, per weekend. So like, you know, either repeating old games workouts or, you know, putting, you know, little spins on games workouts that have already been announced